Hello, I'm Detective McDonough with the Bradenton Police Department. I'm here to ask you a few questions. I'm looking for a, Jeffrey Sinclair.
Yeah, that's me.
Do you mind if I come in for a few minutes?
Yeah, sure. Come in.
Thank you for seeing me, Mr. Sinclair. I'm going to be asking you a few questions about the incident that occurred on the 17th of this month at SCF. And I'm going to be recording this discussion for my own personal notes.
That's fine. Glad to help.
Okay, then. Let's begin. This is Detective McDonough, questioning Mr. Sinclair about the events that occurred on May 17th, 2011, at South College of Florida. Can you please state your full name for the record?
Jeffrey Michael Sinclair.
Did you know Mr. Davison before the incident?
Can't say that I did. Who is he?
He's the man you killed, Mr. Sinclair. Hey, are you with us?
Yeah, I'm here.
Okay, so were you in the first class that Mr. Davison attacked?
That's correct.
Do you know what time the shooting occurred?
It was about 5 minutes after I got to class.
And what time does class start?
It starts at 10, but I was late.
Why were you late?
I don't see how that's relevant.
Answer the question, Mr. Sinclair.
I left my headlights on. I had to get a jump from my neighbor.
So how late do you think you were? 10, 15 minutes?
Yeah, that sounds about right.
What happened when he walked in?
When he came in, he was real loud. Like he kicked the door open. As soon as I saw him, I dropped to the floor. Just in time, too. Right when I did, I heard gunshots.
How many gunshots?
7.
You seem pretty sure about that.
I can still hear them.
Alright, 7 shots. After he stopped shooting, what happened? Did he say or do anything?
I don't know. I kept my head down. When I looked up, he was gone.
So he just burst in, fired a few shots, and fled?
Yeah. Probably took him 5 seconds to kill them.
Samantha Rogers, Justin Larson, and Frederick Johnston. Did you know any of them?
Can't say that I did.
I knew who they were. I've had classes with all of them before. But I've never hung out with any of them.
Okay. So after Mr. Davison left, what happened?
I laid there for I don't know how long. I didn't even notice Sam lying on me until I felt her blood.
Then what happened?
After I pushed her off me, I looked over and saw Fred slumped over in my usual seat. It was all I could really focus on until I heard the screaming. It was Fred. He was lying on the ground, just screaming.
So Mr. Johnson initially survived the attack?
Yeah. He was still alive when I left the room. There was a med student that was giving him first aid. I asked her if there was anything I could do to help, but she said there was nothing I could do. She was just buying him time.
So that's when you decided to go after him?
No, I still didn't know what I was doing. I mean, one second we were going over differential equations, the next we were being shot at.
So what made you decide to go after him?
I don't know, a bunch of things.
As in?
As in seeing all the pain and suffering he caused. As in hearing Fred tell me that he didn't want to die. And knowing the only thing I could do was promise him he wouldn't. As in the fact that Justin was dead because I was late to class. I should have been the one slumped over at that desk. But I wasn't. I had to do something. I was meant to do something.
And that's when you decided to leave?
Yeah. That's when I left the room.
So you heard more shots and saw Mr. Davison walking away from a body?
He was walking so nonchalantly, too. Like he didn't give a shit.
And that person was dead when you got to...
Yeah. There was a bullet hole in her neck. Looked like she bled out pretty quick.
Did you try to resuscitate her?
I checked for a pulse in a couple places. And when I dropped her arm, it was so lifeless and limp, I knew she was dead.
All right, please continue.
I started following him again. At that point, I still didn't know what I would do when I caught up with him. I saw him shoot a few more times, but I didn't see any more bodies. I guess I did pretty well at staying out of his view because he never shot at me. I got pretty close to him as he was about to go into the cafeteria.
The cafeteria is where the confrontation went down, correct?
Yeah, that's where I caught up with him.
I was about 15 feet from him, hiding around the corner. I saw him walk in, and I knew I had to stop him. I mean, it was right around lunchtime. The cafeteria was full of people. As soon as he walked in, I ran in after him.
Let me make sure I got this right. You ran in from behind and tackled him. He ended up on top, punching you several times in the face. You saw the AK-47, grabbed it, and rolled over to see Mr. Davison lunging at you with a knife.
Yeah, that's how it happened.
So he's coming at you with a knife. You have the gun. What happened next?
He was right on me when I turned around. I didn't have time to react before he jumped on me and put his knife in my chest. After that, I just unloaded on him.
He was on top with a knife in your chest. How did you manage to shoot him with him being so close?
When he jumped on me, he pushed the gun down. The rifle was underneath him. I used all the strength I had left to push him up and pull the trigger.
So he stabbed you, then you shot him and passed out.
Yeah. The last thing I remember is pulling the trigger.
You've been very helpful with my investigation, and I hate to do this. Mr. Sinclair, you're under arrest for the murder of Mr. Davison.
Are you fucking kidding me? You're serious, aren't you? This has to be a joke or something.
If you could please stand up and put your hands behind your back.
You can go fuck yourself! I'm not putting my hands behind shit! If you just comply, this would be much easier!
Detective McDonough with the Bradenton Police Department.
Is that right? I don't think that was it.
It's just a tongue twister, right?
Bradenton Police Department.
Bradenton Police Department.
All right, we got this. Are you ready?
Hello, I'm Detective McDonough with the Bradenton Police Department.
Samantha Rogers, Justin Marston, Frederick Johnson. Do you know any of them?
Can't say that I did.
You moved, and I looked right over.